Hey, we are headed out to the Black Mountain Wilderness for a little winter fun. We're going to go explore the canyons, look for some petroglyphs, any kind of relics or anything. Maybe put a little coil down, see if we can find a coin or two. Brought the pistols, going to do a little shooting out here. Just left Hodge Road, did a little shooting over there. So, but yeah, we're headed out. We're going to see what we can find out here. Alright, we'll check back. Opens up a little bit. Gets a little bit more rural out here. Coming up onto where the pavement ends. This is it. This is like probably the last couple of spots for housing, and then you're approaching the wilderness boundary. So this is it. It's the end of the paved road. Alright, we are right along the wilderness boundary. So there's the pole. Anything on the right side of the road now is wilderness. Everything to the left is just a desert BLM. So we are just about to the canyon. Pulling up here soon. There's Black Mountain there. Not too bad of a road. A little sandy. So far, probably two-wheel drive with decent tires could be out here. All right, we're almost there. Smoothed out a little bit as we approach the canyon. Able to go about 45 safely. No big bumps. A little bit of washboard. Alright, here we go. We are at BM 6271, open route to the canyon entrance. We are turning. The road forked. We're headed this way. That's another road. It is showing up on my GPS, but this is the way to Black Canyon. Still leading that way on there. Yeah, we're headed up. This is the mouth of the canyon here. Pretty cool. So there's the fork down there. Just came from that way. We noticed some petroglyphs over here, so check them out. Awesome looking rocks in here. Look at that. That's neat. There's probably some arrowheads in this stuff for sure. I think that's the blue looking stuff is chert. So, I think I saw some in here. Let's see what we can find. Yeah, right there. These are probably some of the better ones in the area unmolested because not a lot of people notice. There's one right there. Nice. These are some good ones. Been around a long time. On the back here too, but I can't make them out. Okay, came up into the rocks a little bit more. There's some good ones in here. Look at that. And then right over here, there's like a little animal looking one. And there's some dots. See the dots right there? There's some more way up there. They're all through here. Look way up there. There's some good ones up there. Look up there. There's a good ones. All right. We'll go up there and check those out. We'll hike a little bit. I'll come back in a minute and we'll check back in when we get there. Another panel right here. Pretty cool. It's one of the bigger panels. I'll give you reference. Get up on the rock.
face. I saw some more up here. So I'm gonna walk up there and check those out too.
Hiding in the rocks here. There's all kinds of little ones in here. You gotta look at any of the flat faces that have been sitting in here. Possible weather station or something over there, maybe. Yeah.
All right, we're gonna go up. I thought I saw some up this way.
Okay, check that out, guys. That's neat. It's like a miner's pick or something. And then right there, look at this little intricate stuff. It's almost like somebody was just practicing. It's old though. You can tell it has its desert varnish is starting to fill it back in.
But there's some right over there that we want to see.
1965 modern BHS. Look at this view, guys. Wow. That's something else.
Okay, there's like a, it's a petroglyph here. It's hard to read though. It looked like there might be a bighorn right in there. And like a footprint there or something. It's kind of messed up though.
Cool. I'm check for some more. And a couple more.
One there. There's one right here. That's a good one. That one's fairly unmolested.
Cool.
Still up top here, way up high. The calendar here, that's neat. It's a good one.
There's some peckings right there along the edge of that. That's cool, this is a good one. Very neat.
Finding these little shards here and there. No arrowheads or anything up here. Found a really small grind hole over this way. But coming around the mountain right now. Gotta check to see if we find any other man-worked stuff. Like, that looks like that could be worked a little bit. It's a little bit unnatural. But that's quite smooth enough to be anything. Might have been used a little bit. Nothing yet. Haven't seen any more petroglyphs on this side. Cool. Check back with you.
Little cactus action up here. Check that out.
We're back at it. We're in the Inscription Canyon mouth here. Mouth of the canyon. Good panel right here. Showing water, seasonal water, and then some other stuff that I don't know what that stuff means. I've seen these before. I think they're called zoomorphs, something like that. But that definitely signifies water. Pretty cool. Unfortunately, there's a lot of modern stuff in here. If you look up on the canyon walls up there on the top, some idiot painted their names. So somebody stole the sign. But there are some old ones in here that are Pioneer petroglyphs. 1921. If I could find it again, I'll post it in the comments. But there's some backstory on some of these pioneers and stuff like that. They talk about who it was and where they were headed, where they were from, all that stuff. So a lot of modern. But there are some really good panels in this canyon. And there's some more in this canyon that are hidden, so we'll go check those out as well. but most of these are pretty modern, and there's some old ones mixed in. See, that's an old one there, 1874. San Francisco bound miner there, huh? Pretty cool. Some old ones, some new ones. People are just idiots, man. They put all this stuff in here and, like, that doesn't even look old. Those are old. They're too white. When they're real white like that, they're no good. But, some old stuff in there, maybe. Let's go check down here and get out of here. We gotta go find camp for the night. It's gonna be a cold one. Rather get settled before it's too cold and dark. Know where we're at. So, you can see where the water comes rushing around, comes through here, undercuts. You can see the stain from the sand. Pretty cool. We're headed that way. Came from that way. Search of a campsite right now, but just stopped off to show you guys this old cattle trough here, water hole, 1940. Pretty cool.
It's like Starbucks coffee.
I'm gonna have to check this out. Hey guys, we are in Scouts Cove. Made it to Scouts Cove. Heard about this place in a couple books, but I never. I can't remember what it was about, but I came across this. It's like it's carved straight into the rock. It'd be very tempting to camp in here tonight. It's out of the wind. It's pretty neat, actually. Somebody built a shelf. There's a read this. There's a story a guy told about his dad taking him here. Some candles, some batteries, and some doodads in here. A lot of fires have been had in here. Tell with all the soot. Somebody left a little bit of wood, but pretty cool. I think there's more to it. There's some workings out here that look like they were used for mining out over that way. Might be another cave. This is a neat place, man. This is really cool. Grill, some seats, big campfire spot. Unfortunately, we can't camp here tonight. The wind is just blowing straight in. Might not be so bad inside there, but I got a 10-foot tent, so that ain't gonna work. So we're off. We're gonna go find a campsite still. Pretty awesome. Stuff you find in the Mojave. You guys to see this sunset. This is our spot. I don't know how. Okay, there we go. A little light. I pretty awesome. There's the old school tent. I've had this tent for 20 years. Yeah, 20 years I've had that tent. I got it at Target. I'm taking it out here to basically destroy it. I don't know, the wind's just about done it. But as you can see, the stakes, the thing that holds them, the little grommet pieces are gone. They're plastic, they're broken. And I'm going through the actual material. This is like a thing, so luckily it had that. You see the wind is pulling up the stakes. So, wind is ripping out here tonight. We will have a fire. Got ourselves a fire pit. Little one there, already made. So, good night on the desert. We'll check back in around dinner, show you a little bit of that. Our sunset. We're mostly settled into camp. We're just trying to get our food cooked. The winds have been wreaking havoc. We have some dogs going. And I got the beans cooking in there in the fire pit on the MSR. It's got to cook it slow because it'll burn. It'll just burn. We got two cans to cook on the beans, so I got one there and got another one around here somewhere. But we'll be full, plenty of food. Got a little bread to go with it right there, so that'll be good. Awesome sunset and some decent food. Fire's lit, just letting it burn down. We're gonna add some logs. We got lots of wood. It's early in the night, so we might be either kicking it in the Jeep a little bit or going to bed early, but we'll just see how long the wood lasts. We got some pretty big logs out here, so they should last. This is all orange wood, burns real hot, so let's give it a chance and see how so the night pans out. Sun is down. Probably about 38, 39 already out here, or maybe even colder. It was in the low 40s when we set up when it was still sunset, so it's definitely in the 30s now. Probably getting down to in the teens, upper teens, or low 20s tonight. I know it's pitch black out here. Maybe you can see this. Little moon action around the corner. I'm not sure this is going to turn out or not, but it's lighting up. Let me see if you can see my hand. I don't know. But anyway, you might be able to see the desert a little bit. If not, at least you can see the moon. We're over here. Use the light, I don't want to fall. All right, I'm around the corner here. It is butt-ass cold out here. Low 20s for sure. There's the moon again. This is what we got going on. Stay warm. We've been just chilling next to this. It's helping. Got all this rock reflecting the heat. It's pretty nice.
It's cold.
It is cold out here, though. Gonna be a cold night. Alright, fellas. We got up just now. 24 degrees this morning up in the desert. Garmin, we have the Garmin out, and it's saying the same thing, so 24 degrees. I think the game cam caught 21 degrees or something like that at one point. We didn't have any visitors last night. There were no visitors from any kind of animals. But cold morning. That's what it looks like where we camped. It's pretty cool. It was a cold one. Not a bad night though. All right, we'll see you out there. Camp is clean. We, when we were chilling here, eating breakfast, we noticed up on this hill, these lava rocks look like they might have some petroglyphs on them. So before we leave, we're gonna go up there real quick and check it out. See you up there. Okay guys, we made it up top. It's quite the view. So as we were saying, we had a hunch that maybe the natives were up here and used this as like an observation area, because you could see game or anybody coming from a long way. That valley in front of you right there is at least 5 miles across out there in that far distance ridge line, at least. So they could see stuff from a long way, and if something came running through here, they could get down there and ambush them. They probably had shelters, little rock shelters in this valley that they hid in. You can even see a riverbed that seasonally flows right there. You see it? So that's definitely, signs that there was sustainable life here in this valley. They probably lived here somewhere and there was a village in this valley. But back to the petroglyphs. So check these out. Looks like I've seen this in Utah and I've seen this in New Mexico. This is like I believe this is a calendar showing the water and then the plants. And I believe what you're seeing right here is right down there. So the water comes out of this canyon from this direction, and they planted a farm all right here. And so they caught the water, and they probably dammed it up a little bit so it would last, and then they planted their food, and then they would just leave it and come back to it whenever it was done. I believe that's what they used to do right here. It looks very much like the one in Parowan, Utah. There's a similar setup. So that's probably what that is. But there's all kinds of petroglyphs in here. There's more up here. There's some up in here. So we'll go check them out. We'll stop off at all of them and show them to you. And we'll see what we can find. Hey guys, made it up to the next one. Check this out. There's all kinds of moss right here. It's really cool looking. It's good. It's like orange, green. It's neat. But the star of the show, of course, are these petroglyphs. This is definitely some sort of timekeeping calendar of some sort for some reason. And these, I believe, are called zoomorphs. It's like a shaman would usually be responsible for those vision quest type stuff. There's some smaller petroglyphs in here that are kind of aging. That could be a very old one. And then there's another one right here. Saw those at the ones down over here. So there's probably some kind of relation there, no doubt. There's some other ones in here. There are little ones in there hiding. There's quite a bit. There's lots of, you can see signs of pecking right here. So it's just faded. Whatever was there is long gone. You can see little bits there. We saw this one earlier in the video, like the pickaxe looking one. So that's probably like tribal of some sort. But look at this view. I'm on this seat right here. It's like a ledge. And man, from this spot, look at this. The wilderness out there, the Mojave wilderness. It's beautiful. Cold morning, low 20s. Seesaw before breakfast. pretty neat. All right, guys, let's go find some more petroglyphs. Some really faded ones here. They are dated. They're newer, but they're not new. It's not like somebody vandalized. Those are definitely right. You can see there and there. Let's see if we can find some more. Yeah, there's one right in here. Check that out right there. That's pretty cool. Let's see what else we got.
See those?
All right, we'll check back. Somebody was practicing a long time ago. This is like where they began. You can see some practice marks here. That's actually pretty rare to find that. Usually they finished what they did. I've only found a few in the thousands of petroglyphs I've seen, like where they didn't finish it. So that's kind of neat. See a couple out here like that. There's a little bit more in there, right there and there. That's cool. A little bird nest in there or something. Rat nest, pack rats. Now the pack rats were known to take native artifacts and stuff them into their nests. So there could be all kinds of native artifacts in here, like points and beads and stuff. It's pretty neat. I know archaeologists love finding pack rat nests because they can easily date places because of what they find inside the nest. So that's cool. There's a lot of older petroglyphs in here. I'm seeing them, but the rocks have changed over the years. See, look at, they've changed over the years and different weather patterns and stuff, so they're kind of hard. Some of them are covered in moss. Depiction of an animal. Looks like a crude bighorn on the bottom and something else there, like a snake on the bottom right there. Some animals. Looks like maybe an elk. I don't know. Hiking a little bit along this rim, came across this. Three lions. Cool. We're gonna work our way this way. We're right here. Looks like it's about it on this rock face. I was hoping to find some pictograph action, but nothing yet. Into some panels. Looks like maybe a turtle right there. Hard to say. And then there's some in here. They're faded though. These are, I think a long time ago, these were depictions of springs or water. Hard to say. But I've heard some different interpretations of stuff like that before. Alright guys, some really good panels in here. Check these out. Some of the better ones I've seen in this collection. Look at that. Wow. A lot of calendar action here. You can tell they were keeping time for a while. Who knows why? Or what was for, but some good ones in here. Let's see. Some good ones over here. We'll check on those. huge nest. I don't want to disturb it, but it looks like a hawk nest or something. It's big. We are now at the top of the plateau. But check this out, like, look how this is, man. This is a neat place to just sit. Come over here and then, boom, cliff. Not that high up above the floor. I'd say it's about 100 feet. But look at this view. That's crazy. Incredible views. I love it. Adventure for Petroglyphs is over. Headed back to the car to get out of here.
Got out, coming into the narrows of the canyon to head out of here. Pretty much water would come through here any given time, but you could tell that the water is very seasonal now. Back maybe 200 years ago, it was a little bit more of a flow, probably ran as a creek through here. But not anymore, just a wash, flash floods. You can make it back here with a two-wheel drive, but you know, do it at your own risk, but you could do it.
Black Mountain.